Now, China fears that the Philippines will put up a structure. They have put a structure. I mean, if you see Subic Reef today, right? Now it's literally, how would you describe Subic Reef? It's a military infrastructure island. Is that accurate?
Yes, Subic Reef is one of the three major air and naval bases of China in the Spratlys. It is a 3 kilometer long airstrip. Any fighter jet plane or bomber plane of China can land and take off in that place. It has anti-aircraft missiles. It has anti-surface ship missiles. It's a military air base, naval and air base of China.
Okay, now Subic Reef, Mischief Reef. Do you believe that China has plans to essentially put up another air base or a structure in Escoda Shoal or Sabina Shoal?
Well, it's very possible because they need to put up an outpost there to prevent us from getting the gas in Reed Bank, because that's very near Reed Bank. And they're probably thinking that we would also put up a structure there because we want to protect also Reed Bank. But that is our right, because it's our EEZ. We have the exclusive right to put up a structure within our EEZ.
With the arbitral ruling, was it clear? Did it say that the Philippines can put up a structure in Escoda Shoal? And I'm asking this only because there are parts of the arbitral tribunal decision wherein they've remained neutral or said it wasn't under their jurisdiction. They've said Spratlys is a common fishing ground for three countries. But was it clear that the Philippines can put up a structure?
Yes, because the moment the tribunal ruled that that is part of the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines, it automatically follows that we have the rights of a coastal state to an EEZ. UNCLOS specifically expressly states that in the exclusive economic zone, the adjacent coastal state has the exclusive right to put up a structure to manage the area, to protect the marine environment, and to exploit the natural resources. So we need that structure to monitor and to protect the marine environment, to prevent China from destroying the coral reef, and also to exploit the gas in nearby Reed Bank.
Okay, so we've filed a protest, but you have the Philippine Coast Guard issuing a statement, so to speak, and let me read it to you. The spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea, Commodore Jay Tariela of the Philippine Coast Guard, said China's fear that the Philippines is building a forward deployment base in Escoda Shoal is unfounded. Should we actually be in this defensive position of assuring China we aren't building a structure? I mean, couldn't this be the play of China?
Well, I don't think we have a plan right now.
Okay.
But we should say that we don't have a plan right now, but we can always put up whenever you want, because it's our
Exactly.
exclusive sovereign right.
Because to say that the fear of the Philippines putting up a structure is unfounded, Justice, doesn't that play into China in a way? China wants the assurance that there will be no structure, right? Good morning. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
All right, perfect. All right. Let's just go back a bit to this declaration that China is citing. So they're citing the 2002 Declaration on the Conduct of Parties in the South China Sea, claiming the Philippines has not honored or followed a single one. Now, I know this already, in effect, the arbitral ruling supersedes. Right? Supersedes this declaration. But out of curiosity, what exactly are they citing?
Well, under the 2002 Declaration of Conduct, it says that the parties shall not occupy unoccupied features as of that time. But it also says that the party shall resolve the issues in accordance with UNCLOS.
Yeah.
And we actually did that. So what we are saying is that provision which says that we should not occupy unoccupied features, it is subject to that provision that we should go to UNCLOS to resolve the dispute. And that's exactly what we did. And UNCLOS says, the tribunal says, that is part that Escoda Shoal is part of our exclusive economic zone. And so it's automatically means that the Philippines can put up a structure there, because that's expressly stated in UNCLOS, the adjacent coastal state can put up a structure in its EEZ.
Okay. Now, you know what's interesting is the fact that you mentioned that the declaration cites that there should be no one to occupy to occupy unoccupied features.
And as yet, of that time. As of that time.
And yet China violated it. You have Subi Reef, Mischief Reef. How many did they occupy?
Well, they actually built on nine features, seven or nine features in the Sprat list. The biggest are Subi Reef, Mischief Reef, and Fiery Cross Reef.
Yeah. Okay. Now, you have given recommendations to President Marcos Jr. via this show, and you've said something, the litmus test, because he's already standing firm with a victory, right? But the litmus test, you said, is for him to order the exploration of the reed bank. Now that we have this in Escoda Shoal, what do you believe, what steps should the Philippines take to advance the president's agenda on the West Philippine Sea?
Well, I think we have to send already the survey and drill ship to reed bank. I understand that it should be happening soon because time is running out on us. Malampaya is only supplying two of our largest gas-fired plants. It normally supplies three of our largest gas-fired plants in Luzon. So maybe by the end of this year, it will supply only one of our three largest gas-fired plants. And after that, another year and it's gone. So we really have to get the gas. Otherwise, we will have 12 to 14 hours of daily brownout in Luzon, unless we import LNG, which is very expensive. Our power rates will go up by about 50% if we import LNG to fill the gap that will be caused by the loss of our gas in reed bank in Malampaya. Yeah.
So do you believe the president should also put in his agenda the building of a structure in Escoda Shoal?
Well, it's up to the Navy and the Coast Guard to determine that, because they will have to. It's very important that if we put up a gas platform in reed bank, it has to be protected. And if they feel that there is a need to put up an outpost very near that area, so it would be maybe on Escoda Shoal.
Okay, Escoda Shoal. Now, there's a bilateral consultation mechanism between Beijing and Manila. This is not the first time that this kind of consultation mechanism has been put together. But what should the Philippines be wary of? And what should the Filipino people expect with the bilateral consultation mechanism?
Well, I call it the three no's. Three no's, N-O-S. We should not, there should be no prior information to China when we do Arore to Ayungin Shoal. There should be no prior permission from China when we do Arore, and there should be no on-site inspection on our resupply ships. Otherwise, we will be giving up our sovereign right if we allow China to do any of those three.
Tama. Wait, for the audience, Rore means resupply, right? This is the resupply.
Yes.
Okay, so dapat hindi tayo pumayag na ipaalam sa China ahead of time ang ating resupply mission sa Ayungin. Hindi dapat tayo magpaalam sa China sa ating resupply mission sa Ayungin. At hindi dapat tayo pumayag na ma-inspect ng China ang ating nire-resupply sa ating mission. Tama po ito, Justice?
That's correct, because we have sovereign rights over that area. That means we have a right to go there and to put up a structure. The moment we ask for permission, or even just giving, we are required to give information of what we're doing, we're losing our sovereign rights.
Oh, we are. Okay. Now, when it comes to Ayungin Shoal, very briefly, I wanted to ask you on this. At some point, the BRP Sierra Madre will disintegrate. There's been a discussion on this. In the beginning, there were two vessels, a former President Joseph Estrada. It was during his administration that the two vessels were actually stationed in parts of the exclusive economic zone. One was withdrawn, one remains. Should that vessel be replaced at one point, or should a structure be put up in Ayungin Shoal?
Well, you're right. During the time of former President Estrada, we beached two landing ships, one in Ayungin Shoal and the other one in Scarborough Shoal. But during the time of President Arroyo, we agreed to remove our landing ship in Scarborough Shoal because the Chinese vice premier would refuse to come here to visit the Manila unless we removed that ship. So we removed it, and look what happened. After we removed it, China took over Scarborough Shoal.
Yes.
So that's a lesson for us. We should not agree to give up our sovereign right to occupy our EEZ or even our high tide features like Scarborough Shoal. Yes. So I think the BRP Sierra Madre has been retrofitted to last for another 10 years.
Okay.
But my recommendation is to put up a civilian structure there, a lighthouse, a marine research center, and probably a Coast Guard substation, because the tribunal said the BRP Sierra Madre is a military ship, and the tribunal has no jurisdiction, because we complained to the tribunal that our ships were, resupply ships were being harassed, but the tribunal said we cannot do anything because that's a military activity. We have no jurisdiction.
Yeah.
So we should convert our presence there to a civilian activity. And that means a lighthouse, a Coast Guard substation, and a marine research center. But let's keep
Can we retain both? Is it possible?
Yes, we can retain both.
BRP Sierra Madre and put up a research center
Yes. That's
civilian near it.
Yes, we can. We have 10 years to put up that a lighthouse. So we can keep both at the until the BRP Sierra Madre collapses.
Okay, all right. Now, before we move on, I wanted to ask you about the International Criminal Court just very briefly this morning. The Solicitor General hasn't actually seen the actual document that states certain personalities are under, I believe it's a blue notice, if I'm correct. You can correct me on this. Or they're possible suspects when it comes to the extrajudicial killings during the time of former President Duterte's administration. Just practically speaking, what can the ICC really do? Let's say you are a suspect in their investigation. Given the fact that the Philippines is a sovereign nation, the justice system is working, we are not members of the ICC, how far can it go? Can they actually arrest a former president, a sitting senator in the country? Do they have the right to do that?
Well, first of all, let's take it one by one. They can come here to question some of the witnesses, because it's up to the witnesses to agree, no? If you don't want to be questioned, then you just don't agree. So they can come here to question witnesses, and subject to the consent of the witnesses, and our government said they can do that. on their own. Now, to arrest, that's a different matter because we have already withdrawn from the ICC. And under the extradition law, the requirement is that we can honor an extradition provided there is an existing extradition treaty. Mm-hmm. And that provision on extradition is gone now because that's supposed to be in the Rome Statute, the agreement that we signed in being a member of ICC. But there is another convention, the UN Convention Against Transnational Organized Crimes, where we can possibly entertain a request by Interpol to effect the arrest of any person accused by the ICC, but it's very problematic. I was looking at the provisions, yeah. And it's very easy to bring that up to the Supreme Court because under the extradition law of the country, there must be an existing extradition treaty before we can honor that. And in the case of the transnational convention, anti-transnational organized crime convention, the offense must be committed in at least two countries. Mm-mm. But in this case, the extrajudicial killing happened here only. So it might not qualify. So it's very problematic. I would recommend to the government to just rejoin the ICC.
Yes,
so it will be very easy to effect any arrest warrant issued by the ICC. And I think that's the right thing to do. Just rejoin the ICC.
Yeah. So technically, now that you're explaining this, the withdrawal of the country from the ICC, President Duterte's withdrawal from it essentially protects him today.
Well, it protects him from arrest, but it does not protect him from the jurisdiction of the ICC because under the terms of the ICC our accession, crimes committed while we were a member can still be pursued by the ICC. And that's what the Supreme Court said. Our Supreme Court said that for crimes committed before we withdrew, that can still be pursued by the ICC. But the problem now is under the extradition law of the Philippines, we can honor a request for extradition only if there is an existing extradition treaty. And there's none anymore as of now. So the ICC can continue with the prosecution, but they will have a problem of asking us to effect arrest because there is no more, we are no longer a member of ICC. And there are problems with UN Convention against transnational organized crimes because the EJK happened only in one country, did not happen in two states.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you for our interview this morning. So it's clear that you've just said it's so much easier if the Philippines just rejoins the ICC.
Yes,
that's correct. Thank you so much. Former Supreme Court Associate Justice Antonio Carpio. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Karen. Thank you to our viewers.